In this video, something about parasitic oscillations in audio amplifiers and high frequency amplifiers. Though I have to say that my experience in high frequency amplifiers is limited. It goes to, say, approximately 30 megahertz. There are a lot of problems when you want to homebrew electronic circuits in audio or in radio applications. Here you see a radio application from the 1920s. Here again, one big layout from radio applications. A radio application, a radio receiver from the 1920s. I want to explain that later. What is the problem that when you make a good audio amplifier and when you raise the volume, you get a lot of sounds, say on 1000 hertz or whatever sound, an oscillation. That's a parasitic oscillation. And in general, we can say that an audio amplifier gets extremely sensitive at its input when there is no earth plate. That earth plate has to be from tin plate or iron. Copper, for instance, or aluminum don't have good properties in shielding an electronic circuit, and in professional electronic circuits you will also always see that iron is used. An iron box, so no earth plate is a problem. Could be that such a situation leads to oscillations. The second problem is the no one and only earth connection. When you have an audio amplifier made, there must be one and only earth connection to the enclosure, the metal enclosure, from preferred tin plate or iron. When that's not the case, it could be that you have a double earth connection. And such a double earth connection can mean oscillations, can mean hum, a persisting hum that's generated by a tiny earth current that starts to flow from one potential to another potential, when not all the earth connections are on zero level. No impedance matching is also a problem. For instance, when you have here, say, a preamplifier from an audio amplifier, and the impedance here does not match with the input, say, a CD player or so, and you move the potentiometer here, say in a situation where we have the node, the wiper connected here and here to the minus and here to the positive, and you move that wiper to the minus, it could be that your audio amplifier starts to oscillate. In that case, use a resistor here from, say, 10,000 ohms, 10k, or 22k in case of transistor amplifiers. For tube amplifiers, this is not a problem in most cases. A too high input impedance can also mean a problem. Say you have a field effect transistor at its gate. It could be that the impedance is so high that we get unexpected backcoupling effects, and that means that your audio amplifier can start to oscillate. Output and input wiring close together. Well, this is a quite exaggerated situation. Here we have the input from, say, a CD player, and that wiring is closely connected to the loudspeaker wiring. And here we have electromagnetic coupling in that case. And when the phase from such an electromagnetic coupling is not good, your amplifier will start to oscillate. So keep the input wiring to the first transistor and the output wiring to the loudspeaker completely separated. Well, here we have the ARIM DC resistance radio receiver from the 1920s published in this book. And we now get to a situation where we have radio circuits. And with radio circuits, there are always typical problems. And you can see that here, this is that radio receiver from the 1920s, a very big piece of paper. And this coil is in the horizontal position. This coil is in the vertical position. This in the horizontal position, etc. The reason is that this coil must not couple electromagnetically with that coil. Otherwise, you will get oscillations. So that's the reason why this is horizontal, this is vertical, and this is horizontal too. That's the most important issue when you want to make simple shortwave radios with coils in all kinds of positions. And I've indicated that here also, vertical, horizontal, and horizontal again. To prevent decoupling, mount one coil in the horizontal position and one in the vertical position to prevent coupling. And you can also see in old school radio circuits, for instance, from this book, that coils are mounted all in a certain angle, say 45 degrees, to prevent that they couple electromagnetically. Finally, something from this book, Retro Radio is my book, published in the Netherlands, completely Dutch text. But anyway, the older circuits apply exactly remedies against oscillations. Here, this is the first remedy, and the first remedy is connect an extra electrolytic capacitor over the voltage line. That will help as a first remedy. Second remedy, make a kind of decoupling circuit. So this is the high frequency stage, the medium frequency stage, and also here the low frequency stage. Decouple the high frequency stage and the medium frequency stage with the help of a capacitor. And again, we here see the same issue. Decouple with the help of a resistor here the high F stage. And this is, by the way, the best way to remove all kinds of unwished oscillations, both high frequency and audio frequency. Every stage, high frequency, medium frequency, low frequency, has its own decoupling unit. Here's a decoupling unit, and here and here. So, again, more remedies. Improve the shielding with the help of tin plate. Use a bipolar cap in the power supply line. Could also help. 10 nanofarad up to 100 nanofarad. Preferred ceramic. And this is the final ID to prevent unwished oscillations. Shielding. And here small caps in the 1 nanofarad range to shield out all the disturbing problems from the power supply lead. Many problems about the parasitic oscillations go out of the power supply lead. So again, back to the first part of this video. It was more or less all to tell here. I cannot explain it better. So I hope you liked it, etc.